I can't breathe, I can't see. That's all right.
A wise woman once told me, the greater the penis, the greater the responsibility.
Mm. Yes, ma'am.
She explained how great dick unselfishly satisfies, stroking her alphabets until it meets greets and appeases her G-spot, because in the ideal session, she comes first. She explained how great dick had her eating pussy and sneaking public orgasms.
Wow.
I.e., the greater the penis, the greater the responsibility. She said if the dick is that good, she may have given the dick like access to her credit card.
She's fucked up.
The keys to her car, the dick had a valid driver's license. Her legs began to twitch and she seductively licked her lips as she talked about the time that she was in the back seat and he was in the front seat and how her legs touched the roof and they were singing songs that she could never repeat in church. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
She said, this is the reason why she gets upset with young girls. Say young girls is too busy worrying about a man's shoe size instead of worrying about the size of his anticipation. Said that he's too busy worrying about his baby mama when she knows that he's always gonna come in her, but who's supposed to come first? She said the reality is this. She said boys is too busy trying to impress men, but a man is gonna make sure that that woman comes first, second, and third. Who are you fucking with? She said, the greater the penis, the greater the responsibility. She said, you know what? Young boys need to be trained. Young boys often don't get the opportunity to be in the mouth of a grown woman. Yeah. In the mouth of a grown woman. So when you have opportunities to be taught, them boys need to shut themselves up, undo their pants, and say, yes, ma'am, can I have another? Mm-hmm. I just happened to be at one time in my life an impressionable 17-year-old, and she was something years old.
30-something.
And she just happened to be the mother of a friend of mine, but we wasn't talking about him not being here, and I was supposed to be waiting to play video games, but she had her mouth on my joystick. I kind of had the reality, and when she said, you know, when your eyes arise and there was steam on my glasses, because I was blind then, but I seen how quickly I came. She said, I can teach you things that will make grown women chase you for the rest of your life.
Nice.
Wait a minute.
She said, there is a patience in being taught if you are willing to learn.
That's right.
She said, most people are superstitious about where they put their mouth, but if it's delicious, what are you complaining about? She said, growth is inevitable, but this is the place where you redefine time and you have it where whenever you show up, you show out. She said, underwear is not an option when you walk in this bitch, so do not disrespect me and bring them with you.
Wait, oh shit.
So as an adult, I have a no panties clause.
Did he say that?
As an adult, I have a no panties clause. Once we get to where we're going, your panties should be off anyway.
Nice.
I don't
want
them. Oh shit.
She said, the greater the penis, the greater the responsibility. She said, I'm going to train you. And when I train you, I'm going to name you. And whenever I see you in public, just smile and nod your head. Because for the rest of your life, any woman you touch from this point forward will owe me the gratitude of their orgasm.
Eric Crow Draven. Eric Crow Draven. Eric Crow Draven.